All right. Good morning, everybody. It's time to learn some successful key tips on how to have the perfect home sale. And we're going to do that with our friends with Fidelity Bank, Amber Lampe. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. You brought in a very special guest.
I did. I have Tom Miller here, and he is going to share with everybody how they can get, you know, the things that are very important on how you list your house and a little bit about the market, and he's definitely an expert.
So. All right, well, thank you so much for joining us this morning on CW Iowa Live. All right, so we're always talking to Fidelity on how to get into our dream home, but sometimes in order to do that, we have to sell the current home we're in. So what are the keys to success so we can do this in just the right way?
So there's really, I call it the three P's.
Three P's.
Which are the keys. So the first one is pricing.
Okay.
You've got to price your home well to get it sold. And, you know, there's 75% of the success of a home sale is due to pricing your home.
Okay.
If you don't, you know, you see a lot of homes that may linger on the market, but you notice once they make that final price reduction, it sells like that. So once you hit that right price, you're
there. Because you never want to come in too low.
You never want to come in too low, but actually in this market, you almost can't come in too low because the market will bid it back up to the market price. If you go too high, you run the risk of your house lingering on the market. And the longer your home's on the market, the less it becomes worth. It's kind of like the analogy in real estate is bread. So when it's fresh, hot out of the oven at the grocery store,
everybody wants it.
They're going to pay a bunch of money for it. Mm-hmm. But if it's been sitting there for a week, it's not worth as much.
That's an interesting analogy.
Yeah. So homes really kind of have that same thing. It's over a little bit longer time frame, but your home is going to lose value over time on the market.
And do people look at a house differently if it's been placed at one price and then you have to drop it down?
Absolutely.
So people have a bad taste in the mouth.
People will start to watch and wait, and they see if you've come down a time or two, they're gonna be like, oh, they'll come down again.
Okay.
And so we'll wait. So it is super critical to price your home well right out of the chute. And you've got the best chance in the first 10 to 30 days to get the most for your home.
All right, so that's the first P. What's
the
second?
So the second one is promotion.
Promotion.
And you know, that's marketing, that's in today's world, that's social media.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of different keys to having good promotion. You know, everything from the newspaper isn't as big a deal as it used to be. But you know, there's tons of websites today. And again, Facebook is huge.
As you say, social media kind of taken over when it comes to the housing market.
It really is. If you look at the history of real estate before the internet,
right,
the social network were realtors. Well, today, everybody else gets to play along. And so you'll notice when somebody puts their house on the market, they're sharing it with their friends on Facebook. Mm-hmm. They're putting their listing out there and sharing it with everybody. Realtors, you can target market people. So you can target people that are looking to make a move.
Okay.
And it's very interesting what you can do with social media today. And it's really having a big effect on how homes sell.
As someone who's not actively pursuing, I'll have friends that do exactly what you're saying. They're sharing a house that's for sale because they know somebody or they think it's a great deal. You'll see it on social media literally minutes later. It could possibly be gone already.
It's that fast. I've had homes sell. I mean, within a couple hours, you'll get, you know, you just create this giant buzz and there's a ton of activity and all of a sudden, boom, it sells.
It sells. Okay, so we're helping you out with some keys to success here, and we have a third P to talk about.
Yeah, so preparation is huge. Making sure when you decide to put your home on the market, you're taking your home from being your home and turning it into a product.
Mm-hmm.
And if you think about selling products, you know, you want to have the best looking product that you can possibly have.
Right.
So, you know, the simple thing is cleanliness and decluttering. But, you know, you want to look at things around your home like deferred maintenance on the exterior. So how's your siding look? Is your front door, your front entryway is your first impression point for your home.
Right, kind of curb appeal.
Absolutely. And so when somebody's walking up to that front door and realtor's unlocking the front door for you and everything, you're standing there kind of taking the house in, and that's your first impression right there. And so that is the most important place in your house. Carpet's huge deal. You know, everybody.
Really?
Yeah, nobody has time to worry about in today's world. Well, gosh, I'm going to move in. How do I get this carpet put in before I, you know, get my furniture here and that kind of thing. So it's a big deal to make sure your carpet's in great shape. Paint, neutral colors is a big deal.
So you as a homeowner yourself, should be looking at the carpet, the paint, the siding, doing a little investing in the home.
Absolutely.
So that it can have the turnover that you're looking
for. Absolutely. And so, and part of the service that I offer is I have a professional stager that on all my listings I send out, I actually pay him to go out and give my clients the list of the things that they should do to make their home present the best and sell the fastest for the most money.
And are we cooking some chocolate chip cookies to get it a great aroma too?
Never hurts. It never hurts. I mean,
for me myself, but also to help sell the house.
Absolutely.
Okay, so let's talk about how the very first piece, pricing. How do you come up with that listing price? Do you have some hints?
Pricing is art and science.
Okay.
So, you know, you really have to look at the local market, and the tighter you can get to the neighborhood, the better, because all over town, every neighborhood has different dynamics on how things are selling. You know, location matters, and there's a lot of different things. So you want to look at the homes that are actively on the market, what they're priced at. Now, they haven't sold yet, so you don't know what they're going to sell for. Mm-hmm. You want to look at the homes that have sold in the last 6 months to a year. And then you want to look at the homes that didn't sell, so what are called expired listings. So homes that were on the market for 6 months or longer that just didn't sell. And that's going to, you know, after you analyze those, and it's not just all of them. You want to, so if you have a two-story, you need to be looking at two stories, similar age, similar square footage. If it's a ranch, you need to be looking at, obviously, ranches, similar size, similar age, similar finishes. And you, the more you can narrow that down, the more accurate you can get with the pricing.
Now, we've mentioned this before, but isn't it considered a seller's market right now?
It is a seller's market right now. It's, you know, and particularly in the 300,000 and below, it's just a white hot market. I mean, you get down around 200,000 and those are the homes, and below, those are the homes that are just going in hours.
Wow.
Many times.
Unbelievable. Well, thank you for giving us some great keys to success here. I feel like it's things we could do, but it's probably easier to hire someone that can really guide us in the right direction to make sure we're doing everything just
absolutely,
right.
Yeah. Getting your home ready to sell is different than designing your home to live in it.
Okay.
They're two
That's
separate concepts.
Okay.
You want to set your home up to be inviting and show well, and it may not be the way you're going to live in that house, or you have been living in that house. So.
All right, and Amber, I know you have an incredible team of people, not only that help us with loans to get us into our dream home, but probably how to sell our current home so that we can get everything we're looking for.
Right, yeah, so that's when, you know, someone, you'll want to make sure that you always talk to a local lender. Obviously, we'd prefer you use us at Fidelity Bank, then give us a call, but then we can help you with some of the questions on, I'm not sure what my house is worth. We get that a lot.
A lot.
And that's why you want to make sure that you can be pre-approved for another home, because you want to sell your house, but you don't want to sell your house and then realize, oh, I've already sold my house and now I can't get financing for my dream home or my next home. So really, you want to start with us, and then if you have a question or you're not sure what your house is worth, then that's where we send you to, you know, a Tom Miller or an expert with one of our team members to make sure that you are getting set up, that you are with a professional that helps you through that whole entire transaction.
Getting all your ducks in a row so
that's
things
right.
go as smoothly as possible.
Yes.
Tom, if people want more information with what you do, well, how can they get in touch with you?
My email address is tom@dsmhomes.com. The one thing I would like to say too about Amber is, you know, buying and selling a home is a team sport.
Mm-hmm.
It takes the individual that's looking to make a move, it takes a great lender, and it takes a great real estate agent to make it a successful process. If you've got a solid team, like the folks at Fidelity Bank, the folks on my team, and a client that is able and excited about making a move, it can be a super smooth process.
And that's nice to hear, because sometimes you hear about the stories where it's not so.
Everybody's heard the disaster
stories.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. We're trying to help you out this morning. And Amber, it's so easy to go to one location and have an entire team ready to work for you. And that's what you can get at Fidelity Bank. You're local and you're ready to help.
Yep, absolutely. FidelityBank.house or 343-2300.
All right, folks. There you go. Those are the keys to success on how you can make a very smooth transition of a home sale into your dream home. Fidelity Bank here to help you out. Tom, really, thank you so much.
Thank you
for being here today. We will